DC Studios has released the final trailer of Flash, and it looks absolutely kick-ass, just like the previous ones. Now, in the trailer, we hear Bruce Wayne say that he can save the world but also destroy it, which is exactly the way his powers are. As now that the guy will travel back in time, he will of course undo and alter some things, which will just mess up with the big events of the DCU, like General Zod's re-entry, Supergirl taking Superman's place, two Flashes at the same time, etc. 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 Now, here are the shots I liked in the trailer. We see a couple more shots of Batfleck on his bike, a new shot of Flash's super speed run, an emotional shot between Barry and his mother. Supergirl is just crushing Zod in these shots. A cool shot of Michael Keaton's Batman just chilling in the air with no parachute. Batman's cape can stand against bullets too, mofos. I would call this the coolest shot for me in the trailer. Just look how fast Batfleck is just sliding in that traffic. We also see Flash trapping that bad guy in some kind of tornado. So the final trailer of The Flash has done its job so well, which is hyping the fans for the movie. Now, I'll be honest, this is the only superhero movie I'm interested in watching this year, because I have enough reasons to check this one out. It has Ezra Miller as Flash, who I enjoy seeing as that superhero. It's a time travel and multiverse movie. It has two Batman and two Flash, and last reason, the action shots look cool to me. They are not rated R, but they look so badass. I think the future of DCU and Ezra Miller depends entirely on this film. Its success or failure will let James Gunn and team know what they should do with Flash in the DCU in future. If you ask me, I want this movie to succeed, and remember, this is the last time we'll be seeing Ben Affleck as DCU's Batman. It's sad, it's really sad. His Batman had a lot of potential. Anyway, let me know your thoughts on the trailer in the comments down below. Besides that, I also watched The Calm, an action short film from BMW Cars. It's directed by Sam Hargrave, the genius behind 2020's Extraction, and that fact was enough for me to check this short film out. Well, now that it's a BMW produced movie, their first motive was of course to advertise the car and make it look cool, and I loved how they did it by showing the car in the action sequences. The Calm stars Pom Klementieff and Uma Thurman. It's about Pom Klementieff's character who has to go to a hotel named Martinez and pick up a briefcase and a ticket to the Cannes Film Festival. Now, the short film has two action sequences, and they are good. They are really cool, as of course Sam Hargrave. You can clearly see the hits landing, and there are no jump cuts. Now, here are the action shots I liked in the short film. When Pom's character tries to disarm the driver, his hand movement changes the music. She dodges that taser and kicks and holds him against the windshield. A cool right to left drone shot of the bridge, the car and the bikes. Just look how fast she blocks a left jab, lands an elbow, and then moves from left to right side of the seat. Then there's a bike chase sequence, and it just looks so stylish. Even though there was not much collateral damage in the chase sequence, the cinematography of it is amazing. It's just an 8-minute long short film. If you haven't checked it out yet, you can. It's available on YouTube. And let me know your thoughts on it in the comments down below. And here's a movie recommendation. Sisu, it's a really cool Finnish rated R action movie. It's fucking amazing. It's set in 1944 during the time of the Nazi rule and World War II, where a man named Atami works as a gold miner. One day he comes across some Nazi soldiers, and then the action starts. The movie's fight scenes are brutal, and I really enjoyed it. Sisu just showed Atami coming back again and again, even after getting severely injured, with so much conviction. He's just so badass in the film. If you are a rated R action movie fan, you should check this one out. If you liked this video, let me know by giving it a thumbs up, and stay updated of my upcoming videos by subscribing to Style and Punch and following us on Instagram. Take care and see you in another video.